This photo shows a satellite picture of Indochina region on one night in 2020. As you can see, Myanmar is dark at night. People in Myanmar have limited access to electricity. Access to electricity is something that we take for granted in major cities like Tokyo or neighboring countries to Myanmar like Bangkok and Dhaka, where we all have reliable access to electricity 24/7, 365 days a year. Have you ever wondered how the electricity that keeps the lights on are actually produced? When my daughters were in kindergarten, they asked me, "Papa, what do you do for work?" Well, I told them I work in the energy sector, in the power sector, where we produce electricity. And then the next question comes, how do you generate electricity? How is it produced? Thankfully, we have this book where Oscar the kitten and his good buddy, the bird, were discussing how electricity was produced. So, electricity is produced in a very simple process. You take a fuel, it could be renewable energy, or it could be a fossil fuel. You put it in a power plant, and at the end, that's how electricity is generated. And the byproduct of that process depends mainly on the fuel, meaning that the dirtier the fuel, the dirtier the emission. The cleaner the fuel, the cleaner the emission, or there's no emission. Thanks to my job, I was able to travel through Southeast Asia, where I have met many stakeholders, private stakeholders, public stakeholders, government officials, fellow colleagues, where we have discussed and where I have learned about electricity, how electricity can be decarbonized, and how it's going to be like about decarbonization. Decarbonization is the process of how to reduce carbon dioxide emission, CO2 emission, which are produced when you burn fossil fuel in the electricity production. So now let me share with you my own 5-step plan. How can we have a carbon-free future when we generate electricity? First, use more solar power. Use the sun. The sun is free, it's abundant, it's clean, right? And also when you have a solar farm like this, it can be as cute as this panda-looking solar farm in China. Also, number two, you can use wind power. You can harvest wind, having big wind turbines. Again, free, cheap, right? Unfortunately, the sun, the wind, is unpredictable, intermittent. It means that you cannot predict when the sun will shine or when the wind will blow, right? But you need power every day, throughout the day. So, what do you do when the sun doesn't shine? What do you do when the wind doesn't blow? And this is where battery energy storage comes in the picture, right? Take, for example, your USB power bank that you use to charge your phone, right? But when you use big energy storage system, you take those big batteries, which can be used to store excess electricity when there's excess, and actually you discharge it when it's most needed and when there's no renewable. Fourth, we should start using sustainable fuel such as hydrogen, ammonia, methanol, which actually can be blended with natural gas to actually to produce green electricity. Finally, we should stop using fossil fuel. In a 100% renewable world, we will finally be able to stop burning dirty coal to produce electricity. And these are my five-step plan how to have a carbon-free future in the electricity sector. In November 2021, political and business leaders of the world gathered in Glasgow to discuss climate action during COP26, which is the United Nations Climate Change Conference. It was great to see, to hear many speeches of those leaders stating or confirming their intention to decarbonize the electricity sector in their various countries in order to achieve net zero by a certain timeline. However, it is important that those leaders walk the talk by implementing the necessary action plan and thus honoring their promise that they make during COP26 when they get back home. Climate change is going to affect everyone on Earth. This graph shows you the social and economic impact of climate change. You will have, for example, rising sea level, extreme temperature on the hot side, on the cold side. There will be also lack of access to fresh water. There will also be shortage of food. Well, achieving carbon neutrality is not an easy task. We need everyone on board to make changes. Doing nothing is the worst possible action. This is why we need to act now. We need to act today. You also can have your own five-step plan as how I did. Changes that we make now will unfortunately not have this effect visible tomorrow. Let me give you an example to explain what I mean. When you cook at home a pot of stew, the ingredients that you put together in that pot, it takes time for it to boil, to simmer together, to blend together, to create that unique aroma and flavor of a pot of stew. You need to be patient when you cook a pot of stew. The same, the decarbonization journey is not going to happen overnight. You need to be patient. This journey is not a sprint, it's a marathon. Rome was not built in one day, neither. Everyone has its own role to play in this ecosystem. And if everyone, every single of you here today, join forces and start to change his or her mindset, together we can make it happen. Well, this is why today I'm launching a call for action to everyone to join me in this journey toward net zero. This is probably our last and our best chance to get people in the CSN community to start to think, start to understand, and start to engage in discussion regarding climate change, carbon neutrality. We must all remember that there is no planet B. I'm sure that many of you have watched Star Wars, the movie. Well, I heard that even Darth Vader and his Imperial soldiers are looking to use renewable energy to power up the Death Star. It's free, it's clean, and it's renewable. Why not? Well, if Darth Vader can do it, so can you. Thank you very much.